Buenas tardes. Good afternoon. I'd like to ask our participants to come and join me, Bishop Cisneros, Estela Jimenez, the president of the organization. We are about to begin our press conference kickoff to the Brooklyn Dominican Parade and Festival. Welcome to everyone. Council Member Rafael Espinal, who has joined us, Henry Garrido, who is here as well, DC 37, Executive Director, largest municipal employee union in New York City. So he represents the strongest of municipal workers in the city of New York, the first Latino of Dominican descent. We are very proud as a people. Saludos. Hola. Buenas noches. My name is Diana Reyna, and on behalf of Brooklyn Borough President Eric Adams, I want to welcome everyone here to Brooklyn Borough Hall. Distinguished guests, welcome to today's press conference, kicking off the week of festivities culminating in my neighborhood. As the first deputy Brooklyn Borough President of Dominican descent, representing very proudly 2.6 million people in Brooklyn. I want to thank all of you for all your love and support. I served my community proudly for 12 years as a council member. I represented the 34th district in Williamsburg, where I grew up, in Bushwick and Ridgewood, Queens, where my life revolves 24/7. That is an opportunity for me to bring together with a major leader and distinguished legislator like former Senator, Borough President today, Eric L. Adams, to serve by his side the interests and values and quality of life that we want our borough to continue to thrive for, leaving behind no one. It is with great pleasure to be here today with you to celebrate and kick off our heritage as Dominicans. Como Dominicanos, a donde hay uno, está la patria. This is our future here in Brooklyn and the state of New York. For 15 years, the Dominican Parade and Festival of Brooklyn is an important cultural institution, and we are pleased and excited to work with them and you to continue to support this source of pride, celebrating the contributions of Dominicans to our wonderful borough and this great city of New York. As your Deputy Borough President, I look forward to continuing to work with all of you, especially those who have founded and continue to work hand in hand to continue to see this culture of Dominican heritage. Estela Jimenez, who is our president and founder, and all of its board of directors. I'd like to just recommend the opportunity to seek and absorb what is not just a festival and parade, but understand that this is the first time after 15 years that this committee has decided to expand this festival and parade for a full week, embracing what is not just a people and a culture and a heritage, but making sure that we're going to embrace what is government, politics, here at Borough Hall, kicking off tonight and culminating throughout the week, celebrating Latino shop owners. We are calling for people to go and support your mom and pop stores as we are here. Accompanied with us is Rick Miranda. Rick, come and join us here. Rick Miranda is the executive director to the Brooklyn Kings County Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, and making sure that Brooklyn's small business, Latino small business, is always at the table and that its voice is heard. It is what represents its truest of efforts in making sure that they are thriving. And when they thrive, our communities thrive. They are the small employer. They are the people like Aquinos, who has provided us with our light refreshments this evening, a new restaurant that has opened in Bushwick. And we want to make sure that people understand when we support them, they support us. They will employ the next door young person who's looking for a first opportunity to understand the culinary arts, to understand to run a small business and what it requires behind the scenes. And they take out that young person from the street into a conducive environment mentoring them. It is Aquino's restaurant that will do the job and stay connected to community, especially in communities like Bushwick, where we want to seek opportunity for the concentrations of our people. I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome our borough president, our first African-American, oh, si, gracias. I have our borough president telling me to remind me to speak in Spanish. Buenas noches a todos. Deseo darle la bienvenida esta noche a todos ustedes por estar con nosotros representando tantos sectores de nuestra comunidad. Esta semana estamos ya por primera vez, esta noche, celebrando lo que es una expansión de una semana de actividades, patrocinando con la organización del Brooklyn Dominican Parade and Festival, el festival y la parada de Brooklyn Dominicana, que fue cultivada hace 15 años. Es su 15 aniversario. Y esta semana va a ser expandida para dedicársela no solamente a un desfile y lo que es un festival, sino dándole apoyo a aquellos de artistas, como ustedes ven alrededor de esta rotonda, que estamos viendo el compartir del arte dominicano, de un artista dominicano. Lo que es nuestra comida, el restaurante, queremos que ustedes vean el día dedicado que vayan a patrocinar los negocios latinos en nuestro condado de Brooklyn. Que nadie se quede atrás celebrando cultura, que nadie se quede atrás hablando idioma, que nadie se quede atrás viendo lo que somos nosotros, humilde gente que venimos a trabajar, contribuir a esta gran ciudad. Me da mucho orgullo y gusto de servir nuestro condado de Brooklyn, representando lo que es siendo la primera dominicana elegida para un cargo de concejal hace 15 años, con ahora servir como vicepresidenta al lado del nuevo presidente, primer afroamericano representado este condado de Brooklyn, 2.6 millones de personas. Es importante que ustedes vean el liderazgo de arriba para abajo, que esa voz de ustedes nunca se pierde, que ustedes estén siempre conectados a esta institución. Por eso estamos viendo de que aquí, hoy y esta semana va a ser una unidad celebrando una cultura, pero una de tantas que estamos celebrando en este edificio. Que ustedes como dominicanos, latinos y Brooklynites, como nos llamamos, siempre estén queridos, apoyados, para que nadie nunca se quede atrás, porque es pa'lante que vamos. Ahora, en este momento, quiero darle la bienvenida a su presidente del condado de Brooklyn, Eric L. Adams.
Thank you so much, and my job is really an easy one. You know, Henry, you got to always have folks around you that could do your job for you, you know. So my job is an easy one, and, you know, I cannot say enough about what our deputy has brought to Borough Hall and the Borough of Brooklyn. And so it's easy to make history, but the goal is not just to make a check off of changing something or moving a person into place. It's about showing that we have the quality that is needed. And so we have a qualitative deputy borough president, and it is shown every day as we continue to move forward. And I remember hearing, you know, my good friend, the head of DC 37, I remember him sharing, you were sharing your story one day about your family and coming up through the ranks. And it is the experience of the Dominican community, it's the experience of so many communities, how we've all saw our parents eke out a living and made it possible for us to arrive at the moments that we are now at to have this celebration. And we cannot thank the board and all those who are part of this great experience. And we're doing something that I think is important by placing the flag and allowing the flag to be flown on top of Borough Hall. You are sending a strong signal that the Dominican community, this is your borough, this is your building, this is your time, this is your moment, and continue to move forward and make history. We are also going to light the building in the colors of your nation. You can experience the beauty of living in America without abandoning the culture of the Dominican community. That's what's great about this country. You do not have to give up your heritage, your culture, your experience, your language, your sound, your music. All that you contribute is what makes this country great. It is the accumulation of all the different ethnic groups and all of the energy and spirits that comes with it that gives us our flair and our flavor. No one wants to live in a garden with one flower, therefore we should not live in our lives with one flower. It is the flowers that all of us bring to this garden we call Brooklyn that makes it a great place. And so I want to read the proclamation. Whereas on behalf of all Brooklynites, I salute the officers, members, and supporters of the Dominican Parade and Festival of Brooklyn Incorporation for celebrating and sharing the richness of the Dominican culture, folklore, and popular traditions, and to highlight and promote the heritage and contributions of the Dominican community. I applaud the exemplary leadership of Estela Jimenez and the officers for organizing this joyous event of music, dance, and tradition, food that strives to unify Dominican and Latin American communities. I commend everyone for their hard labor and tireless effort to make the Brooklyn Dominican Parade a success, especially this year that marks the 15th anniversary of the parade. And I thank everyone for all that we have done to make Brooklyn one Brooklyn. I sign my hand and signature, Eric Adams, Brooklyn Borough President, mark today, do hereby proclaim August 24th to the 30th, Brooklyn Dominican Parade Week in Brooklyn, USA. And what I really enjoy about what is taking place that we're going to duplicate is that it's more than just a parade. It is an entire week of sharing the culture, and as the deputy stated, of shopping in our local businesses, the food, educating Brooklynites of the rich culture of the Dominican community. And I think it's an excellent way of celebrating the entire week. And we're going to make sure we're going to move that week to an entire month, you know? So thank you. Thank you so much. We're really, Estela, we're really proud of what you're doing.
Thank you. It gives me great pleasure to be able to introduce the representation of Dominicans in the city of New York, not just in numbers, but in personality and the efforts of advocacy and love for neighborhood and family. And today we've been joined by Council Member Rafael Espinal of East New York, Cypress Hills, Brownsville. Push it, Rafael Espinal.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Buenas tardes. It truly is a pleasure being here. I want to thank the Borough President for all the work you do on behalf of Brooklyn. I have to say, I believe I represent the most Dominicans that there are in Brooklyn, in my part of the district. I have Bushwick and Cypress Hills and East New York, And this borough president has been there on every step along the way. Throughout his 2 years in office, I've seen him more than I've seen some of other elected officials in the neighborhood. So thank you, Eric Adams, for all the work you do on behalf of those neighborhoods. And it is truly a pleasure standing here next to Diana Reyna, one of the first Dominicans elected to office here in New York and the first female. So Diana, thank you for what you represent and what you do also on behalf of Brooklyn and Dominicans. I was actually the first Dominican voter into state office in Brooklyn. So it truly is a pleasure at the age of 26. My parents came to Brooklyn from San Jose de la Mata, Sihanico, in 1968. So they were part of the first wave of Dominicans coming into this country. And because of what this borough and this city had to offer, they were able to buy a home and raise six kids in this country. And I was able to run for office and represent not only the Dominican community, but the neighborhoods I love and grew up in. So it's a pleasure being a Dominican. It's a pleasure being a part of this parade. We all think of Dominicans living in uptown Manhattan and in the Bronx, but they're here in Brooklyn, and we have to make sure. We have to make sure that the city knows that, and that we have a borough president standing behind us, making sure this is one Brooklyn, and that he stands with the Dominicans. So thank you guys all. Thank you for this evening. Thank you.
Bueno, si Rafael ya dijo de dónde viene, voy a tener que decirlo igual. Mi mamá viene de Burén de la Vega y mi papá de Las Agüitas Tenares, del Cibao. So, I just mentioned the parts of the Dominican Republic where my parents come from. Since Rafael went there, I had to go there too. My mom is and dad are from El Cibao, the mountain regions. Cibaeña, por las macetas. At this moment, I'd like to just call upon our beloved Bishop Octavio Cisneros. Auxiliary Bishop Cisneros was born in Las Villas, a province of Cuba. And it is this borough president who raised the flag in unity on the day of International Day of Friendship, raising the Cuban flag to embrace what is happening behind the scenes, front and center, with the politics of opening the doors for the very first time in a long time with the connection of una Antilla, una parte de las Antillas, Cuba. And for us to have risen that flag was symbolic for us Latinos. Whether there's a difference in politics, we have to put that to the side, but alienation is no way to bring people together. And the borough president continues to share that message through his motto of One Brooklyn. July 1945, the third of four children, Roberto Cisneros and Olga Lescano, both now deceased, shortly after his birth, his family moved to La Habana, where he was baptized in Our Lady of Montserrat Church. The Pirist priest educated him as a youngster, and in October of 1961, while a high school student, he came to the United States as a political refugee, as part of Operation Peter Pan, a Catholic humanitarian effort that brought 14,000 unaccompanied minors to the U.S. from Cuba. Let us never forget those trying times. Relocated to Marquette, Michigan, I always Latinoize everything. He attended and graduated from St. Paul High School in Neguni, Michigan. He went on to St. Lawrence Minor Seminary in Mount Calvary, Wisconsin, where he earned an associate's arts degree, and Niagara University, where he received a bachelor's degree. Bishop Cisneros' first year of theology studies took place at DeSalle School of Theology in Washington, and he completed his theological studies at the Immaculate Conception Seminary, Huntington, Long Island, Earning a Master's in Divinity degree, he was ordained to the priesthood by Bishop Francis J. Mugarbero on May 29, 1971. It gives me a lot of honor and privilege to be able to call upon Bishop Octavio Cisneros, who's beloved amongst all Dominicans and Latinos alike. Bishop Cisneros.
Mr. Adams and the beautiful Deputy President, you make us proud. You make us proud. I wish that she would have skipped everything that she read on my biography. I would have preferred that she would have said, well, the bishop is not from Tenares, and he's not from Bonao, and he's not from Santiago, but he is one of us, and that I am. I think that one of the characteristics of the people of Brooklyn and Hispanics is that when we come together, we take the nationality, we take the culture, we take everything that makes that other person to be who he or she is. And indeed, when we come to a Dominican parade, I can, with all consciousness, say, I am Dominican today. And I hope that when we go to the Puerto Rican Day Parade, we say, we are Puerto Rican. And when we go to the parade, that beautiful parade that we have here, of the Caribbean islands, that we also call ourselves members of that Caribbean island. Because indeed, we are one city, we are one borough, we are Brooklyn. Así que es indiscutiblemente un placer poder estar aquí y celebrar quiénes somos. Celebrar nuestra cultura, celebrar nuestra fe en Dios, celebrar todo aquello que nos ha hecho ser quienes somos. No solamente el arte, las comidas, el baile, sino también nuestra fe en Nuestra Señora de la Alta Gracia, en las Mercedes, en el Cibao, en un Dios que nos ama y que nos guía. We come today to ask God's blessings upon all of us in the Borough of Kings as we inaugurate the festivities highlighting the presence and the contributions of the sons and daughters of Quisqueya. We join the rich cultural variety of all the peoples that come from every part of the world and enhance our city. Today, in particular, we salute the human and spiritual values of the people of the Dominican Republic, values that speak of the dignity of the human person, the ethics of work, the love of family, the integrity of word and action. And so I will ask you for a brief moment to bow your heads and to pray to Almighty God that He may bless our festivities. O Lord our God, pour out on us a spirit of truth, understanding, and peace, that we may know with all our hearts what is pleasing to you, and with one accord pursue what we have come to know. Almighty God, we offer our prayers for our borough, that through the wisdom of its leaders and the integrity of its citizens, harmony and justice may be assured, and lasting prosperity come with peace. Te lo pedimos en nombre de Jesucristo y su Santísima Madre, Nuestra Señora de la Alta Gracia, en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Amén. Felicidades.
At this point, I'd like to call up Vice Consul Dominicano Nelson Pimentel. We have been joined by Vice Consul of the Dominican Consulate, Nelson Pimentel, and his Associate Press Director of the Consulate, Adalberto Dominguez.
Muy buenas tardes. Nos sentimos realmente muy orgullosos y comprometidos con esta comunidad de Brooklyn que nos acompaña en esta tarde. Somos cibaeños. Muchos saludos al presidente Boro, Eric Adam, por recibirnos tan alegremente. Algo que nos caracteriza a nuestro pueblo es esa sonrisa del presidente.
He enjoys your smile.
Adam, Eric Adam. Porque nuestro pueblo, como todos sabemos, es la unificación de tres razas que en un momento dado hicieron punto estratégico, la raza, si se quiere, el grupo europeo, grupo aborigen y el grupo africano. Bien, esa mezcla ha hecho, si se quiere, un escándalo. Somos escandalosos donde quiera que llegamos, nos distinguen y nos sentimos alegres en todo momento y agradecemos que esta comunidad de Brooklyn nos digne en enseñar, en dar muestra de lo que es nuestra historia y poder enseñar que somos hospitalarios, que tenemos un país, si se quiere, pequeño, ubicado estratégicamente en una área donde muchos países geopolíticamente han tratado de hacer, si se quiere, dirigir, pero en base a la dignidad que se ha hablado aquí, nosotros hemos tratado con mucha dignidad de trabajar y de llevar hacia adelante el proyecto democrático donde ya hoy por hoy nuestro presidente Danilo Medina ha podido en 3 años erradicar el analfabetismo, algo que no manchaba mucho para nosotros, un pueblo ya a estas alturas, que se pudiese hablar de que habían analfabetos. La ignorancia, si se quiere, es el peor de los enemigos que puede tener un pueblo. Felicitamos a nuestro presidente, Danilo Medina, por aclarar la mente de nuestro pueblo en base a la erradicación del analfabetismo. Esperamos que nuestro presidente Boro nos visite, el señor cónsul, arquitecto Eduardo Selman, mandó su excusa y queremos recibirlo allá y hacerlo sentir bien para que vea nuestra muestra de alegría siempre.
So, Vice Consul Nelson Pimentel was just extending an invitation to our borough president to visit the Dominican Republic, to embrace what is an invitation that will allow him to see and feel the sentiment of its people, to understand the politics and how much we've achieved in the Dominican Republic. One of the greatest agenda items on the president's priorities is dealing with ignorance based on the fact that there is a lack of education. And the mere educating of its people is how the country has been able to move forward. And that investment in not just the children of the Dominican Republic, but the adults and those grandparents to understand that there is no mountain region high enough and no valley low enough where education isn't important, because it is the fundamental basis of a community forging ahead. He also recognized the races that comprise the people of the Dominican Republic, the Afro influence, the indigenous, and the European. And that is a complicated mix, but never denied. And we embrace them, we're proud of it, because it makes us stronger people, because we are very much aware of how different we are and how our characteristics bond us, because division is easy to achieve, but unity in one country is more difficult to remain and continue to fall upon. And so we appreciate the words of President Danilo and its consulate and joining us here today. And it gives me even greater pleasure to see Council Member Matthew Eugene, who has joined us. Thank you, Council Member Matthew Eugene, our first Haitian American elected to the council and government in the state of New York. And so this is the bonding and recognition of people coming together for One Brooklyn, for Brooklyn Dominican Day Parade and Festival. It is that message that we must continue to embrace, because it is easier to divide and conquer. It is harder to bring people together and work together for a greater common good. I'd like to call upon Henry Garrido. Henry is such a well-respected individual, and it gives me such honor to be able to call upon him as our first Latino representative executive director of the largest municipal union of employees in the city of New York, DC 37. And he is Dominican, proud and humble and distinguished, Henry Garrido.
Thank you so very much. First, I hope that invitation includes some cousins, so you might have to invite me, Eric. I know all the spots down there, so it's indeed an honor and a pleasure to be here and stand here with you. I want to take a moment to thank the borough president for all his great work, not only for recognizing the community, but also fighting for us. You know, somebody mentioned his great smile and the pleasant demeanor, but this man has proven from day one that he's not afraid, and that he can and will always speak truth to power, no matter who and what organization may become uncomfortable. And for that, we as a Dominican community, I believe, should be really, truly thankful for his continued support. So give him a hand. And to his deputy borough president, I don't know if you know this, but I'll tell you a little story about that, because despite everything she said about her background, I have seen every bit of fighting Begana blood in Diana. We sit on the pension board of the NYSERS, which is one of the largest five pension boards here in the city of New York, overseeing investment of over $60 billion. And every time we get in there, that we see one of these companies come in there, and Diana and I are sitting across each other, and the issue of investing in economically targeted investment for minorities, of women-owned businesses, you can see that face light up, and you can see that it's about to come. And I say, you know, so I am extremely proud to call Diana not only my friend, but a fellow fighter in the fight for economic justice in the city of New York. So I want to thank you. And just a few weeks ago, we had an opportunity to, I'm a board member of the Dominican National Dominican Day Parade. We had a parade out on 6th Avenue, and I see a fellow board member, Maria Curi, who's standing around here. I want to thank her for joining us on the work. So I want to wish the best to those who are organizing the events, because truly there's a lot of work involved. Since everybody was talking about the pedigree, yo soy también dominicano. Yo nací en Los Minas, pero mi familia es del otro lado del Cibao, de la parte este, de Atomayor, no lejos de San Pedro, donde vienen muchos de los peloteros que las personas conocen. Y yo nací y me crié allá, hasta que vine aquí después de terminar high school. And I moved first to Corona with my mother. Eric referred to the story that I've been trying to tell people. But later on, as I enrolled in architecture school in City College, I moved here to Brooklyn. I lived in Decatur Street, and from Decatur Street, I moved to Cypress Avenue. I lived in Highland Avenue. I lived in Edna Street. I lived in, my mother to this day lives in Logan Street, not far from here, in the council members' district. And
I have to say I had an opportunity here in Brooklyn to not only be embraced, but I have an opportunity to have a place where my culture could not only be celebrated, but not discriminated. And so I am extremely proud to stand in front of you as a product of the success of the many community, Dominican-Americans who are in our community, who represent not only a small sector in business, in education, in arts, in sports, but also in labor. Because I represent working people. About 125,000 working New Yorkers and about 60,000 retirees, many of which reside in the borough of Brooklyn. And I remain extremely proud that have the distinct honor of being the first Dominican of being elected to head the major municipal union. But I've always said that with great power comes great responsibility. And so it's not enough that we are the largest minority here in New York, but we have a responsibility to organize in ways that we've never done. And for that, I'm extremely proud that since the last election, there have been 80,000 Dominicans registered since the last presidential election. We are not stopping there. It is our desire to register 250,000 new Dominicans. My union is leading a charge with working people. There are others who are doing the same with community. And so for that, I stand very, very proud. Again, congratulations to all the organizers, to the borough presidents, to the deputy borough presidents. Y pa'lante, que si se puede. Gracias.
Felicidades, Henry. You make us proud. Continue the good work. And all know that we have a responsibility to ourselves and our people domestically and internationally. When we organize, we teach the world. Because when New York City does it, anyone else will follow. And always remember the power to the people. And at this moment, I'd like to call up Estela Jimenez, our co-founder, president, and organizer to this grand parade. And she comes prepared more than ever before because the new structure of the National Dominican Day Parade, under the leadership of so many, but one of which our dear Maria Kiri is here with us today, supported by the National Parade, first time ever where there's a unified effort to making sure that this is not just about the citywide effort, but our local neighborhood efforts. And so it gives me great pleasure to call upon Estela Jimenez, president of the organization.
Okay, voy a hablar en español, en mi idioma. Le doy las gracias al borough president, honorable Eric Adam, a la la señora Diana Reyna. Y le doy las gracias también a todos los representantes de organizaciones y también a la prensa. Muchas gracias por estar aquí con nosotros. Antes de continuar, quiero llamar parte de la directiva del desfile dominicano de Brooklyn. Somos tres fundadores, como diríamos, Duarte, Sánchez y Mella. Señor. John Luis, Doctor Lorde, Santa María. Que pase por aquí el señor Max Caicedo, uno de nuestros colaboradores. Señor Caicedo, venga por acá. La señora Angie Williams y sus hijas, que son una fuerza voluntaria en el desfile dominicano de Brooklyn. La señora Inés Sánchez, voluntaria, familia de todas esas niñas bellas que ustedes ven por aquí. También el señor Carmelo Feliciano, un colaborador completamente para el desfile dominicano de Brooklyn. Y demás directivas están trabajando porque son gente humilde y tienen que buscar el pan diario cada día para sostener su familia. Quiero darle las gracias a Denise Feliciano, right? Felipe Adams, la cual ha estado apoyando muy profundamente también. Venga por aquí. La señorita Marisa Baez, también pase por aquí para que vean toda la persona que está con nosotros colaborando. Y también quiero darle las gracias a una persona aquí muy especial, la señorita Yaminki Crisóstomo, al señor Malcolm, también, que es colaborador. Ok, lo hemos invitado hoy aquí para que lo ayuden a difundir la apertura de la herencia de la Semana Dominicana aquí en Brooklyn, la cual la más relevante es el día 27 de agosto, en el Yando de Uora vamos a tener la noche de gala, así que lo esperamos los que puedan asistir. Y también tenemos nuestro desfile el día 30 de agosto y festival. Comenzamos desde la avenida Graham y Debe Boys, continuando todo Graham Avenue, ese desfilódromo, caminando hasta llegar a Grand Street y Graham, continuando Grand Street Bushwick, donde ahí ya vamos a terminar en la escuela, East Industry High School o Grand Street Campus High School, donde vamos a tener un festival hasta las 8 de la noche. El cual queremos darle las gracias al doctor Justino, quien siempre nos da abre la puerta para que realicemos cualquier actividad. La señora Marilyn, Miss Dioclesis Santos, por favor, pasar por aquí también. Es una también colaboradora en el desfile incansable. También vamos a tener la Semana Dominicana, vamos a comenzar con una película dominicana que la vamos también a presentar en la escuela Grand Street Campus desde las 5 hasta las 9. Continuamos el miércoles con una presentación para la comunidad dominicanos al doctor, porque tenemos que mantener informada a la comunidad para que mantenga su salud, ¿ok? Nosotros trabajamos mucho con la salud, porque eso es lo que nos da el soporte para seguir adelante y mantener nuestra familia. También vamos a tener el jueves, pues, el banquete, como ya le dije, en el Yando de Bora 400 de Kent y Broadway. Y ya el día 29 vamos a tener Latino Chat, que es la compra, su rebaja de un 10% en las compañías que ya están, que estén trabajando y que hayan aceptado en esto. Hoy ya el día 30 va a ser el gran desfile y festival. Ahí es donde vamos todos a reunirnos como hermanos y quien vamos a cortar la cinta ese día, el Borough President será el gran mariscal internacional y nuestra queridísima la de Puridiana Reyna va a ser la madrina nacional del desfile. Esa bella mujer, así que vamos a aplaudirla. Tenemos también aquí nuestras reinas, yo quiero que le den un aplauso a las reinas. La reina del desfile dominicano de Brooklyn 2015, la señorita Paulino, cariñosamente Gigi. So, yo deseo decirle de que siempre nosotros estamos apoyando cada actividad en la comunidad de Brooklyn. No miramos de que es dominicano, simple miramos que son nuestros hermanos. Okay, quiero introducir al señor Joe Wiss, uno de los fundadores del desfile, y después viene el doctor Lolé Santa María. Venga, señor Wiss.
Thank you so much to the committee of the Dominican Day Parade in Brooklyn. This is going to be a festival, a parade, a week culminating in many different activities, and we just wanted to make sure that you are able to join us and start the week with our kickoff and end it participating and enjoying yourself on Sunday on Graham Avenue, Avenida Puerto Rico. And we just wanted to pay special tribute and gratitude to Kelvin Morel, whose artwork is displayed in this rotunda at Brooklyn Borough Hall. His artwork will be at the auction for the gala on Thursday on Giondo's on the Water, and we welcome everyone.